and the color. Because it seems for some reason it's expected that I'd be happy with just one. So you have to be a person of color, emphasis on the person, ignore the color, where a Starbucks cup in my hand validates myself and ideas as human. Because now that I'm normal, I'm basically white. Never mind the way that I talk to my parents or get ready or even watch a movie. For the sake of their comfort, that's not who I am. To them, I'm dyed hair and the way I hold a fork even in an Indian restaurant. To them, I'm only as big as my assimilation will allow, as they cling on to any piece of perceived whiteness, perceived normalcy they can grab onto to justify even talking to me. Otherwise, I could be a person of color. Emphasis on the color, ignore the person. When someone asks where I'm from, where I'm really from, before they ask my name, and they tell me about how one time they went to India to find their spirituality, never mind the diversity of cultures and experiences in India, and the diversity of experience in my life. To them, one tourist trap trick means they already know me. To them, I'm an exotic caricature of ideal housewife and primitive culture. To them, I'm only as small as my assimilation will allow, as they cling on to any piece of perceived stereotype, perceived fetishization, to justify even talking to me. Yeah. So the second one is called Things I Read in 17 Magazine. My friends and I didn't read 17 Magazine every day at lunch. We didn't read it because we weren't 17. We were only 12 or 13, so instead we studied it like a textbook. Learning what to like and dislike, learning what would matter when we were in high school with the big kids. Article 1 said to make sure to know what to do with your tongue. When you kiss a boy, spell the letters of the alphabet and hide your teeth. Don't go too fast or too slow. Let it be natural and at the same time well rehearsed. Compose symphonies out of pre-written sheet music and record them over old CDs. The first time I kissed a girl, it was on a stairway, and I can't remember what I did with my tongue or my teeth. It was in the movement of rehearsal with our arms around each other in the accompanying fear of falling down. And it was nothing like a symphony, but instead of pleasant silence with no notes or repeats, just peace. And maybe I did it wrong, but she kissed me again. Aww. Sorry, Mom.
Come on, wearing a bindi has never killed anyone. Mm-hmm.